my name is Misha, and today I'm going to show you how to make gluten-free crepes. So, the first step is you need to crack the eggs. So I'm going to take one egg. You can have as many eggs as you want, depending on how much crepes you want. Okay, so in these ingredients, between each ingredient, you need to just whisk it a bit. The next ingredient is sugar. You only need to put a bit, so I'm just gonna drizzle some sugar. If you want it to be a very sugary crepe, then put as much sugar as you want. But I advise you stay little with the sugar because it might make your crepe a bit too overpowering. So next you're gonna put some vanilla essence or vanilla extract. Not that much. I put too much. Sorry. You just need a teeny bit. Now my eggs are gonna look brown. Next, you're gonna put some milk. This will lighten my eggs up. You don't need this much milk. Just blah. So then, we're gonna put some flour in it. And you can use any flour you want. I'm using gluten-free whole grain flour. I'm gonna put most of it in, because if it gets too thin, later we're gonna use this part to make it a bit more thick. Because if it gets too thin or thick, if it gets too thin, you need to put more flour. If it gets too thick, you need to put more milk. So, this is my crepe pan. Okay, so next, you're gonna put your pan to medium heat, and I guess heat it up for about 3 minutes. Then, you're gonna put some butter. And you don't need to use butter for every crepe that you make, because you're gonna end up making a lot. But you can, but if you're cutting down on fat and butter, then you wouldn't want to. So I've already heated my pan, so my butter is sizzling. You need to move it around, like in the omelet video, I showed you how to move it like a hockey puck. You need to do exactly that. Okay, so now you're gonna put the crepe mix in. I have it right here. And you should get, it would be better if you get a bowl with a spout so it can pour more easily. You need to pour into the circles about this big, and then you need to take the handle and swivel it so it gets in a circle around the whole pan. Now while you're swiveling, if you want, you can just shake it a bit to get it in the corners. And then, after you've done that, you need to make it a bit more thin if it's a bit too thick. Then you need to wait till the edges get brown. Remember, it takes time, so I don't suggest you go away and do something else. I just think you should just wait. Don't watch it necessarily, just, you know, if you have something to do there, then do it. But just know it takes time. Now that my edges are getting brown, you're gonna get a spatula and just loosen the edges a bit. Like this, because the first crepe is always a bit bad because it sticks to the pan. So we're just gonna loosen the edges a bit. Then you're gonna take your spatula and put it under a side with a brown edge. If you don't do it with a side with a brown edge, it might rip or something like that. So it's done now, so I'm gonna take it with my spatula. Oh my god. And there, so there you have a crepe. Okay, so now we're gonna put a bit of Nutella on the crepe. So you can really put Nutella or jam or peanut butter, anything you want. And that is your crepe all plated.